So if there's one thing that I always find so fascinating to watch, it's what's in my bag videos. And the reason for that is because I think it tells you so much about someone depending on what they carry in the handbag. So I thought I would do mine and show you exactly what it is that I carry around on a daily basis. So this is the bag that I use probably the most in my collection. This is like my work bag. It's like a real workhorse, and it is the Prada double bag in the large size. And I have to say that for me, this is a bit of a sentimental bag because it was my first major designer handbag purchase, and I probably purchased it about 2.5 years ago, maybe 3 years ago now. And I have to say that it's held up so well. It's in the Saffiano leather, and what I love so much about this bag that made me think that I have to have this bag specifically is the fact that it has this gorgeous blush pink lining, and I believe that this one's a special edition. I know many people have the one with the red lining, but I've not seen anyone else with the blush pink lining. Quite soon after I purchased it, it was discontinued, so I don't know if you can still get hold of this, maybe on the pre-loved market. But yeah, it has just held up so well. Now, I know the Prada double bag tends to polarise opinion. I think a lot of people think that this bag is kind of a bit of a trend piece. However, for me, I think it's a real classic. I don't think you can really go wrong with a plain black tote bag. I also know that the double bag's predecessor, the Galleria, I think that's how it's pronounced, I'm not entirely sure, is coming back into fashion. I think Prada have tried to resurrect that particular design. So just give you a bit of a closer look at the bag. So yeah, it's the gorgeous Saffiano leather. It comes with a little tag here, and the bag is divided. And what I love about this bag is the fact that it's divided into two main sections with a kind of divider in the middle, which has a pocket, a magnetized pocket, and in there you can just kind of put other things. I feel like it's just such a versatile bag, very business suitable, but also the kind of interior adds that bit of femininity to the bag. I've used it so much, I've stuffed it full of things. I often carry my laptop and water bottle and heavy items. What I also love about this is the fact that you definitely can pair it with a casual outfit as well. So if you're headed out with jeans, it looks really good with, you know, a casual outfit because of the fact that it's a tote. So yeah, it's a very versatile piece, and yeah, very happy with it. So without further ado, let's delve in and see what's inside. So the first thing I've got is a notebook. I always tend to carry a notebook because I like to take notes if I get some inspiration, and, you know, just make scribbles. I'm very much a list person, so that's the first thing that I have. The next thing is something that's very important to have here in Dubai, or indeed anywhere, because we need to protect our eyes, is some sunglasses. They are these Chloe sunglasses that I bought here in Dubai. I actually left my other pairs in the UK. I have no idea how I forgot to bring those along. So yeah, I thought I would buy another pair. I think I only own about 3 pairs of sunglasses, this pair included, because I do consider myself to be a wardrobe minimalist. I don't like to have loads and loads of stuff that's very similar, so yeah. And I had actually been eyeing a pair of Chloe sunglasses, so very happy with these. What I particularly love about these is they've kind of got this detailing here on the side. Just kind of pop those on. And they're also very big as well, so if I'm feeling a bit antisocial, I can just pop those on. I keep them in this very lightweight mesh carrier here, which I bought from Muji. I don't think this is a sunglasses case, but I don't want to be carrying loads of bulk with me, so that is like the best way that I can protect these sunglasses without weighing my bag down. And I've also got the kind of cloth to polish those with. So that's that. In all honesty, I don't carry loads of stuff in my bag because I just try to keep things to a minimum. The next thing I have is this holdall, which is from Harrods. My best friend and I bought these when we were in London on a weekend away, and we both have the same one. I think we bought these many years ago, but yeah, I just still absolutely love this. And what I really love about it is the fact that it's got this beautiful red lining as well. And it wasn't that expensive, you know. So yeah, in here I've got some SPF 50. This is by Clarins, very important here in Dubai because it's sunny, but even in England or anywhere, we need to be protecting our skin. Next, I have some alcohol hand sanitizer spray. What I love about this is the fact that it's like credit card size. You take the top off and then you can just, I think I'm running a bit low on this one. You can just spray it and it's good for your hands, but also, you know, if you're kind of sitting at a desk or something, or you're at a cafe or something and you just kind of want to wipe down the surfaces, you can just go ahead and spray a bit of this alcohol spray and wipe it down with the tissue, and then it's nice and sterilized. Next I've got my EarPods Pro. These are fantastic. I use these all the time, be it for the noise cancelling or also listening to music in the gym, or I listen to a lot of audiobooks as well, so these are essentials. I use those all the time. Next I have this Chanel mirror. I accidentally dropped it, sadly. I bought this in New Zealand, so it's got a bit of a sentimental value. So yeah, I'm a bit sad that it's kind of broken in half. I should probably replace this. So that's the next item. Then I've got the charger for my phone. This is like the plug, but for whatever reason, I think because I'm using it elsewhere, I've left the cable somewhere else, so I didn't actually have the cable with me, which isn't very useful. Fresh breath spray. This one's really, really strong and very potent. I think that obviously I don't think it's good to be reliant on these things, but you know, if you just want to be extra sure that your breath is nice and fresh, then it's good to use these on occasions. Next, I have two lip products in here. One's a Chanel lip gloss in the colour, I'm not sure, sorry. It's a great gloss, but I probably wouldn't repurchase it because I think it's a bit too blue toned for me. But this other product is my go-to product. I've repurchased it millions of times. This is the Chanel like longwear lip gloss, and you have the colour on one side and then a clear gloss on the other. And this literally lasts all day. It's one of those long lasting ones, but it doesn't dry out your lips at all. And I always buy it in the colour Timeless Beige. I've repurchased this so many times, and I will buy it again so many times. It's probably my most worn product. Really, really recommend this. Next, I just have some painkillers. I don't often use these. I try to avoid taking painkillers, but I think sometimes if it's an emergency and you've got a terrible headache and you need to concentrate, you just have to take this. I also sometimes get cramps, so it's good for that. Next, I have one sachet of brown sugar, just in case I have a coffee and I can't get hold of any. I don't often put a whole sachet in my coffee, usually I'll just put in half. Next, I have a pen and the access pass to my building, and a spare mask as well. So that's everything that I keep in my little holder there. And I think having something like this is quite good because I do change bags quite a lot. So to just be able to like take that and put it in a different bag, it just kind of saves a lot of time. And I really don't like stuff rattling around inside my bag or potentially making it dirty. It's just like, you know, a good thing to do to have something like that. Next, I have a foldable bag. This is from Marks and Spencer's. These are really, really good to, you know, rather than using plastic bags, and they weigh nothing at all, so that's really good to keep in your bag. Would recommend having that with you. And have in the kind of middle compartment, I've just got a few dirhams. And then right, this is my wallet. This is part of the Louis Vuitton Kirigami set. This is the medium size of them. Sometimes I just use the small size as a card holder, but at the minute, because I've got quite a few cards and change and cash with me, it's just like a good way to keep everything in there. So I'll just quickly show you. It's got this beautiful red lining as well. This also doubles as a passport holder. And in here I just have all of my cards, lots of receipts that have just kind of built up that I need to go through. And I also have some of these, which are disinfectant wipes from Cafe Batil, which is my favourite cafe here in Dubai. I love everything that they make. Honestly, they are just the best. So yeah, that's my little wallet situation. And finally, last but not least, I have a cap here. This is from Nike. And yeah, because it's sunny here, well, sometimes, you know, if I'm just popping to the shop and I'm not wearing makeup or anything, you just kind of want to be a bit more low profile. I just like to put a cap on, or if my hair's a mess, it's always good to stick a cap on. So yeah, that's everything in my bag that's now empty. So yeah, that concludes. Thank you for watching. I know that the items in my bag are not the most exciting, but yeah, you know, it's a very realistic view as to what I would carry in my bag on a daily basis. I've not kind of specially curated these items. So yeah, I hope it's been of interest. For more similar content, do subscribe to my channel, and thank you for watching.